I'm not hearing this.
Tom. Can you hear me?
Nope. Uh-uh.
Tom. Can you hear me?
Yes. Damn it, I hear you.
Good. I'm starting to feel like you were ignoring me.
I am not losing my...
No, Tom, you are not losing your marbles. It is very important that you understand that, okay?
Okay.
You are not losing your marbles. But I have something to tell you, and it is very, very important.
Hello? Oh, hey. My name's Tom Heyman. Welcome to the Sad Bastard Club, coming at you from the MakeOut Room, deep in the heart of San Francisco's Mission District. Sad Bastard Club is a singer-songwriter event that I hosted here for about 9 years. And then when the pandemic hit, we reimagined it as a web series, and here we are. Sad Bastards for tonight are my old friend Chuck Prophe and Sara Gallagher. Can't wait to see what they have in store. So without further ado, let's get down to business, all right?
Well, it's been 10 years now, if it's been a day. Slipped through the back door at dawn. Well, you've kept the room clean, you're unpacked halfway. In your mind, you've already moved on. Come Monday morning, she shuffled downtown. There's boredom and fear on each face. Sleepwalk till payday and join them again in line at the check cashing place. And outside your window, the streetlights snap on, and they beckon like glittering jewels. But you got the door locked and your back to the wall. As you study the boarding house rules.
Thank you.
You toss all your coins in a jar by the door, and they flash just like cheap costume jewels. You keep saying one day that you cash them in. Soon as you know the boarding house rules. Downstairs they're howling drunk, they don't mean no harm. The noise crashes up through the vent. Get down on the floor, tie off your arm, and wonder where all the time went. Cause you saved the money, but you stayed for the show. Only God watches children and fools. You've got your backpack, but it's too late to go. Now that you know the boarding house rules. You know the boarding house rules.
Together and alone. and shout for all the things that are loud in our minds and in the streets for the poor.
Well, Sara, thanks so much for coming down and doing this.
Thank you so much for having me. I love this place, and it's real nice to be back here.
What was the last show you played before the lockdown?
I played Rancho Nicasio with Jacob Aranda the Sunday before lockdown. So it was right before we kind of snuck it in, indoor setting in a bar in there.
That's a great gig in the bar there. I've played that before. That's fun.
Yeah.
It's a really good crowd. What was the biggest thing you canceled?
It's not music related, but I am a studio artist as well, a graphite artist, and I was in the middle of a year-long studio residency program in San Rafael, and I couldn't go to my studio anymore. So that was a real bummer, and I have to admit that the not being able to have a solo show, the final show of the residency, I had big plans for that show, so that was pretty disappointing.
Have your listening / media consumption habits changed at all?
I guess I'm actually just on social media more in general for actual socializing.
Yeah.
Which is strange. And I have really enjoyed watching some live performances on there and, kind of tuning in and it feeling, finding community how I can through that, which is odd, but it's done its job, you know.
Have you recorded anything or have anything in the pipeline?
I am in a band, Gentle Spirit, and we have a record coming out, or an album coming out on December 11th.
Oh, wow.
Actually, so...
Like vinyl, CD, download?
For right now, we're just going to put it out digitally and kind of go from there.
Have you got anything booked for 2021?
No. I mean, I guess just continuing writing and playing and drawing and doing all the stuff that I need to do and just put it out how I can and wait and see.
Well, thanks again for doing this, Sara.
Thank you.
Bye, Zephyr.
Twilight, I'll bring the dawn. I'll be your ball and chain.
They'll think you're weak because you're soft, but I know who's stronger than me. Stereo, Willie built that beautiful thing. They crank Metallica up real loud, jump around the room and sing from their hearts, from their throats, sing at the top of their lungs. Till the neighbors on all sides complain to the cops who never come. They be singing, love me like I wanna be loved. Love me like I wanna be loved. Singing, love me like I wanna be loved. Love me like I wanna be loved. Love me like I wanna be loved. They drank all night and they slept all day in that Polk Street SRO. When the sun went down, they crushed some ice, ordered Chinese to go. And turned that stereo again real loud, singing at the top of their lungs. Till the neighbors got the broomsticks out, called the cops who'd never come. They be singing, love me like I wanna be loved. Love me like I wanna be loved. Singing, love me like I wanna be loved. Love me like I wanna be loved. Love me like I wanna be loved. Make a grown man bark all night, anytime, anywhere. Willie said I had a lion's mane, now I sing at the top of my lungs. Till the neighbors get the broomsticks out and the cops all sing along. They be singing, love me like I wanna be loved. Love me like I wanna be loved. Singing, love me like I wanna be loved. Love me like I wanna be loved. Love me like I wanna be loved.
All right, Chuck, it's great to have you back in the Makeout Room. What was the last show that you played before the end of, before all live music went on ice?
Well, we had gone out to Austin and played, you know, three shows at the Continental Club. And even then, we knew that, you know, that it was time to pull the plug. I mean, the city fathers at that point had shut the city down. And I mean, it was hard to accept, you know. I mean, we played that Friday night. We played that Saturday night. And I mean, I wasn't proud of it. I saw on the internet, you know, a few days later, I was high-fiving everybody in the front row and sweat was leaning into the crowd and sweat's dripping down off my forehead, you know. And I'm not proud of it, you know, but I think we really pushed it about as far as we could. Yeah, it was brutal. When I came home on the flight, I think it was a Southwest Airlines flight. It was like five people.
What's the, you know, the biggest thing that you guys canceled or...
A lot of European dates and a lot of American dates. Really something like a world tour for us. And for me, getting in a van with Stephanie and my friends in the band, you know, Mission Express, driving around the country, drinking coffee, loading into gigs where, you know, we have friends and people are happy to see us and we're happy to see them. I really miss that. It was like kind of a, in some ways, the road is a grind, but in some ways it's also kind of a vacation.
You know, have your listening / media consumption habits changed at all? Listening to more music?
I'm in a book club, reading a book called The Last Taxi Driver, about a taxi driver in Hattiesburg, Mississippi. So, you know, as far as episodic television, you know, there was a time when I was a believer, but I'm good for about three episodes of something, and then I just want to pick up a book, really. But I've been playing some guitar, and, you know, worked on my risotto game.
So, Land That Time Forgot, it came out, and now you guys are sort of promoting it in this netherworld sort of way of online media. And
we got a camera, and we're a little late to the party, but we've been messing around and having fun with it.
I've been following your GarageBand Solutions on Facebook.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard. I mean, I've been saying the last few years when people are recording things with their phone at live gigs, whenever we play a new song, I always say, please, you know, if you're gonna record the show, you know, please include this next song, because it's really hard to get the music out there.
Yeah, exactly.
And Stephanie asked me early on, she said, I understand, you know, I know you, Chuck, and I know how you think. I just have one request to make. Can we not be the first ones out of the gate? Do we have to be the frontiersmen? Do we have to be the first people out there? And I said, I totally understand. And of course, we just taped Mountain Stage in West Virginia. Of course, we were on the first show that they've had in 7 months. I thought they'd had a couple others, but I was mistaken.
So what have you guys got booked for next year?
We've got a bunch of dates booked in Europe for the spring, and we're cautiously optimistic. Right. I mean,
well, Chuck, thanks so much for coming down and doing this. It was really great to spend some actual face-to-face, mass time.
I think it's great that you've provided this way for, you know, singer-songwriters to, you know, get their music out there, and it's cool.
Well, that's the Sad Bastard Club for tonight, folks. I'd like to thank Chuck Prophet, and of course, let's not forget Stephanie Finch. I'd like to thank Sara Gallagher, and let's not forget Zephyr the Dog. And I'd like to thank Justin Fromm for taking this whole thing and making it into something we can watch and listen to. And mostly, I'd like to thank you for tuning in each week. Be good to each other out there, and we'll see you next time. All right?